Hi, in this lesson we are going to write our first story in a storybook. Let's do it! So the first thing that I'm going to do is delete everything inside stories, because this comes with the example when we install storybook for the first time. We are going to write our own components. For that, I'm going to create this folder inside here called car. We are going to create a car component. And inside car, I'm going to create a few files. The first one is going to be in the index.js. The second one is going to be the car.js file. And then I'm going to write the stories. And this one is going to be called car.stories. Another file that I used to do is called constants. And this one is going to have special constants inside the car. We are going to use it in the car and in the stories. So that's why I just move it to an independent file. So let's see how we can fill the content of these files. For the index, what we're going to do is just export the default of the car. And this is because if you have the index, it is going to be easier to just import the car. You don't need the JS, by the way. Every time that we do some kind of import car front, then we don't have to write something like car.car.js. What we can do is write car as the folder, because inside the folder car, we have the index, and the index is porting by default what is inside the car file. This is going to create a better syntax for our imports. Is this or this? And this is shorter. This is repetitive. The first one. Let's go into the constants. Why into the constants? Because I want to show you what is going to have the car itself. So we are going to call this new variable called options. And options is an object that has two attributes, colors and sizes. What I want to expose here is the different colors that our car is going to have. So this is going to be primary and secondary. And for the sizes, we are just going to do small and large. So we already have that. That's pretty cool. You will see in a second how we use those. For the car, so this is going to be a classic React component. So here I'm going to export the car, and it's going to receive a children, it's going to receive a color, and it's going to receive a size. Just a function as usual. And what we're going to do here is we are going to return a div, and this div is going to have inside the children. So our car is going to be a wrapper for anything that we pass in. We have a few things here, some classes that we are going to set, but this is going to be in our next lesson, not now. What I'm going to expose here are the prototypes. So for those that are not familiar with the prototypes, this is a similar approach as the types in TypeScript, but because this course is just going to be JavaScript, we are going to use prototypes here. For the prototypes to be used, we need first to import the prototypes. So having the prototypes, then what I can do here, but the prototypes, they need to be camel case. So the first prototype, this is going to be a null, and is going to be required in our case because the car itself doesn't make any sense. And for the color, and this is very important here, it's going to be a prototype on one option off. And you can pass here an array of options. And this is where our options constant is going to work, because then we can just pass the colors and the same for the size. So I'm just going to copy here this. And I'm going to replace this for size, and I'm going to replace this for sizes. So remember the constants that we define, the colors and the sizes. So what it means is color is going to be one of these colors, and the sizes is going to be one of these sizes. So now that we have the prototypes, we also can define what are going to be the defaults. And before the defaults were set with a property called default props, but these days it's recommended use the default values of the parameter. So what I can do here is if the color doesn't exist, it's going to be primary, and the size is going to be small in my case. I'm going to export default car, and you are wondering why I have the name export and I have the default export, and that's mostly for testing purposes. Another thing that is important, and this really depends on the React version, is to import React here. So import React from React. I know the newest version of React, it requires something like this, but that's okay. I guess this is basically the car, and right now we are not using the props because that's related to the styles. But then for the story, it's pretty simple as well. We are going to have a sport default, remember that. and we will have the title. Then we need to define the component, and in this case it's going to be the car as well. So the car is imported here. As you can see, I don't have to do the car.js because VS Code is able to infer that I have the index file, so that's really good. And then I'm going to write my first story. So it's going to be sport cons, and this is the name of the story. Notice that I'm doing with uppercase because default is a reserved word, so I need to use camel case. And this is going to be a function that is going to render my car. And then I'm going to do something pretty cool. I'm going to define the story of the colors. So remember, we have two colors, primary and secondary. I will have to write the different states of those colors. That means I will have to write a story for primary and another for secondary. But what if we just go and take our options, remember our options, and then we just iterate colors and we map that. And then we have the color. And what I can do is return the car with the key. In this case, it's going to be the index. I can take the index from the map. Usually when you do a map, what you can do is also take the index as a second attribute. And then the color is going to be the color. So that will cover all the colors. And then I can do the same for the sizes. Of course, I need to change these sizes. And then instead of iterate the colors, I'm going to iterate the sizes. I'm going to receive a size instead, and I can change the prop. Okay, that will be enough to visualize something in a storybook. So let's start in storybook. Let's just open the localhost 6006 and see how it looks. So we have a storybook open here. And as we see the canvas. We go to the sidebar. We can see we have the different stories that we wrote. So let's go to the docs. And what is very interesting, as you can notice, is we have the different props here. We have the default value, we have the description is not very accurate, but we'll learn how to fix that. But we can see everything, the colors, the sizes, and the car itself. Of course, we are not seeing any content because we are not really showing anything more than an empty div. What we can do just to see something at least is define a default value for the children. And I can write something like I'm a car. Right now I'm seeing the I'm a car in all of these places, but we want really visualize how it's going to look with the colors and the sizes. But of course for that we need CSS. So now that we have written our first story, in this case a car component, let's see in our next lesson how to apply the CSS for it. See you in the next one.